In this video, I'll show you the complete process of customizing a template and using the built-in free text-to-speech feature. So without wasting any time, let's get started. Alright, this is the home screen, and we created this video in the previous part. I'll move it to a separate folder. If you haven't watched the previous parts of this Clipchamp course, then I highly recommend checking them out to get a solid grasp of this software. You can find the links in the description. Alright, let's create a new video for today. I'll give it a name. First, I want to talk about the latest update to the software. Previously, they had a separate tab for graphics, videos, and music. But now, as you can see, they have combined all those things in the Content Library tab. Personally, I liked it before, but it's the same thing. They have just moved all the content under one tab. You can also use these drop-down menus to navigate to a specific category, and you will get familiar with it after using it a few times. Alright, I'll go to the Templates tab. As you can see, you have a lot of categories here. Let's find some template from social media ads category. You can see the quick preview by hovering your mouse pointer. Let's check this one. Let's try customizing this template. I'll add it to the timeline. And it'll import all of its layers. If I go to the media tab, you can see all the media files used in the template. Let's see the preview. Now these are all the layers of this template. These are the video layers, and these are the text layers. All you got to do is replace these layers with your information. That's it. I have a script here that I'll use to generate a virtual voiceover. But first, I'll change the text layers according to my script. I'll select this layer, and then from the right sidebar, I'll type my own text. You can change the font style and other settings to modify the appearance of your text. Now I'll change the second text. Same method. I'll add my own text. Let's change the text background color. I'll decrease the font size just a little bit. I'll change the font style. That looks better. When I select the third text layer and go to its text settings, you can see an option to add your logo, but you'll have to upgrade to a premium plan to use this feature. But don't worry, I'm gonna show you a solution for this. Click on none from here, and the logo option will be hidden. Now to add your logo, import the logo file into the media tab. And drop it above the text layer. If your logo has a square size ratio, then it might change the video dimensions to a square. So you'll have to change it back to the previous size. I'll align it with the text layer. Scale it down. And position it right above the text. I'll select this text layer. And change the background color to white. To make the logo more prominent. Next, I'll add the company name. And the website address. I'll apply the brand colors. I want this website address to be closer to the company name, but there's no option here to achieve that. So I'll remove the website URL from here. Then from the text tab, I'll add the plain text. And align it with the other layers. I'll change the color and add my own text. Next, I'll change its font style and place it right under the company name. I'll move down the logo just a little bit. I want the logo and this text layer to appear after this main layer has appeared on the screen. So I'll select both the layers by pressing the Shift key, then add Fade In and Fade Out. Let's see the preview. Looks good. Next, I'm gonna generate a voiceover using the built-in text-to-speech feature. I'll copy my script and paste it here. And here you get a lot of options to control the person's voice. You can choose from a lot of languages, and this is basically the accent. If you want a British accent, you can choose English United Kingdom. But I want an American accent for this voiceover, so I'll choose English United States. Then you have a list of person's voices. You can try them out and select your desired voice. I'll choose this one for my voiceover. You can also select a voice style. Let's try it out.
Do you want a website that stands out from the crowd? We create stunning websites that drive results. Take your business to the next level with our expert solutions. Visit www.jecommerce.com and let's build something great together.
Sounds good, but I think my voiceover is a little slow, so I'll increase its speed. You can also change the voice pitch, but I'll keep it to default. Let's see the preview.
Do you want a website that stands out from the crowd? We create stunning websites that drive results. Take your business to the next level with our expert solutions. Visit www.jecommerce.com and let's build something great together.
Sounds great, doesn't it? I'd suggest you to play with these settings to get your desired results. I'm pretty satisfied with the outcome, so I'll save it to media. And there it is.
Do you want a website that stands out?
I'll drag and drop it at the bottom of the timeline. My voiceover is currently longer than the video duration, so I'll remove the gaps in between the voiceover to match the video's length. I can split the layers by pressing the S key and drag it from one side. I'll do the same thing with this. I'll adjust the layers on the timeline. Alright, let's see the preview.
Do you want a website that stands out from the crowd? We create stunning websites that drive results. Take your business to the next level with our expert solutions. Visit www.jecommerce.com and let's build something great together.
Looks great. Next, I want to replace the real estate footage inside this laptop screen. And also the footage behind this girl. There are two tracks of the video footage. The above track has some green screen videos, and the below track has the background videos which are shown in place of the green screen. Let me show you actually. If I select the top layer, go to the effects, you can see that green screen effect is applied to this layer, which is removing the green background. By the way, you can also remove a red and a blue background. So I'll keep these videos as it is and replace these clips with some stock footage. I need some footage related to website development so that it matches with my voiceover. If I go to the stock videos and search for website, it's showing me some relevant results. But see this diamond icon? It means that I need to upgrade to a premium plan to use this. In the previous part, I told you about a free stock website, so you can use that if you want. But I've already downloaded some stock videos using my Envato Elements subscription. But those of you who don't know about this platform, it's a premium website with massive collection of creative content, templates, and stock footage. You can download unlimited files and also generate a license for each item. I've been using this site for many years now. If you're interested in buying this subscription, then you can use my affiliate link from the video description, which will help me keep making more videos for you. Alright, I'll import all these videos into the Media tab. Now replacing these clips with my downloaded stock videos is very easy. All I got to do is drag and drop my stock videos over these clips one by one. Doing so will keep the length of this layer same as before. For this scene, I'll scale down my videos in such a way that my videos fit inside this laptop screen. I'll do the same thing with this. Simply scale it down and then reposition. Same goes for this one. Now, I'll replace videos for this scene. This background looks a bit dull, so I'll do some color correction to it. First, I'll apply a filter to it. Let me select the layer first. And then do some manual tweaking. And that looks good. I'll use this clip for the last shot and reposition it so that the main content is visible. I'll reduce the length of this layer. That's it. Let's add a background music. I'll go to the content library and navigate to music. Let's try to find something from here. I think that will work. I'll trim it from the start. Then split from the end and delete the exceeding part. I'll align it with the layers. Alright, let's reduce the volume of this background music so we can hear the voiceover. Lastly, I'll add fade in and fade out. That's pretty much it. I'll export the video in high quality 1080 resolution. Let's see what we have done so far.
Do you want a website that stands out from the crowd? We create stunning websites that drive results. Take your business to the next level with our expert solutions. Visit www.jecommerce.com and let's build something great together.
That looks great. If you enjoyed this tutorial, then please like and subscribe to my channel so I can make more videos for you. Your support means a lot, and if you want more videos about Clipchamp or have any feedback for me, let me know in the comment section. Stick around and I'll see you in the next video. Have a great day.